So before we get into the finance part of this, it was just dumb luck. Our company just announced something in the press. It may not even hit the press, but it's on your tables. And it's basically, to my knowledge, the first time in financial history where we've been able to make a statement that's contained there, where basically you're taking assets that have not been digitized. There's a lot of misnomers in the world of crypto and blockchain. But if you just accept one idea that digital assets have a different characteristic than non-digital, and so things that you'd become familiar with in digitizing assets, like music, you actually haven't digitized the asset yet, you digitized right to use it. And so an amazing book written by Chris Anderson, I don't know if you remember it, called The Long Tail, where basically said that economic scarcity is sort of shelf space, and when you digitize assets, there's zero marginal cost, and so suddenly you had an iPod and an iPhone, and basically 98% of all content would be downloaded. And so that formed this long tail. It was a bid for assets that didn't exist. So when you think about investments now, investments go through mutual funds and other avenues, particularly for young people. But we think that that's really about to change. We think that we're sitting on a serious revolution. It's tempting to, you know, get up here and talk about intellectual stuff, but if you just say what I really think is happening, we really are about to have a major paradigm shift. It was sort of like, you know, 1994, I remember a hilarious Today Show with Brian Gumbel talking, saying, what is the internet? Like, do you call people with that? That was true. And I remember talking to companies saying, we don't have an internet strategy. And a lot of people are thinking that, we don't have a blockchain strategy, but trust me, you're about to. Because when you digitize assets, suddenly all of those assets will be downloaded. So who's going to download them? And the answer will be people who care, people who are smarter, people who live in the decentralized world. And so more on that in a minute. But I'd like to talk first about, before we get into finance, that there's maybe the biggest crisis we face. We're talking about a lot of scary things. I didn't see the movies, but I saw a lot of tears. So congratulations, I guess, to who made those movies. They're very powerful. But I think the biggest crisis that we have right now is just sort of the dumbing down of humanity with media and social media. And so if any of you have children, you'll be familiar with this sort of moment. And they could care less what you think. And if you don't believe me, turn off the Wi-Fi and see what happens. But it's true, we're all dumbed down. It's like a shock collar. And I admit it too, I lost this for 3 days, and it was the most blissful 3 days I've had until yesterday. Now I'm back on the shock collar, you can't help it. And so we missed the whole program. But that many people are like, I'm too busy to read about the blockchain. You might want to rethink that. And stop looking at the daily, you know, media massacre and so on. And so it's really a moment of consciousness. It's right goes back to the counterculture revolution. We have to elevate our consciousness to see what's happening. This is a three-dimensional moment. And it's even more wild in that we all talk about empowering. We have a gender lens investment business, which I deeply believe in. Empowering women, empowering people from who are kept under the line because they have no ID, certainly no IP. But if you're not aware that these empowering tools are out there, it'll just be more of the same, right? So empowerment is the transfer of power. And if we're not ready to receive that power, we won't do anything with it, or we'll do the wrong thing with it. A bit trippy, I understand. But the decentralized world is a very real thing. The disintermediating world we've seen. Can you imagine your family owned Woolworths? Some of you are too young to know what that is, but suddenly, you know, Bezos and Amazon came right through Main Street America and put everybody out of business. We walk up Madison Avenue, every third store is closed. And so if you're not aware that this is happening, you won't be aware of the power that people now have. And as John Lennon said, power of the people, it is literally measurable and mathematical now how fast this will move. That press release is the first proof, because I've had a lot of people saying, can you show me concrete examples of what's really happening? There it is. You can, if we decided now, if you own this hotel and we say, hey, let's do something cool, let's digitize it. That could be trading next week on the Delaware Board of Trade. as a quote, Reg D offering, a private offering, where other people could invest in it with their heart, their brains, their mind, their cause, what have you, let alone the bigger subject here of renewable and impact. We believe that you'll have digital exchanges where you can pick your flavor, people will pick their own portfolio, I believe 401k type offerings, such as, you know, balanced accounts and aggressive growth and those sorts of things, are going to go away in favor of Colorado medical marijuana and new development in tech zones, art, things that actually probably would have produced far better growth than investing. My way of thinking of it is investing backwards. So the S&P 500, only 20% of those companies are information technologies. So really they trace their roots to the second industrial revolution. So why are we betting our future on that? I'd rather own solar fields in the valley populating Aspen, because it's a growth market and it's a technologically driven market. Art of consciousness, just have a little fun playing with words. Who likes isms? And we had one naughty comment saying they like asms, but that's different. Isms. Isms are things that are designed to keep people down, even though they might have sounded like a collective. So communism, socialism, capitalism, elitism, but racism and sexism. I believe that all of those things will now be thrown out into the bright lights of the blockchain, where you can now declare yourself and your intentions will be unhackable. We can bind ourselves to each other with full transparency, which is what the smart ledger is, with a hard-coded contract, that's a smart contract. And I don't believe that you'll be able to do those things. If 2 billion people don't have their own identification, and suddenly we can fix that for them, we could give them a gift, because the technology wouldn't cost that much. Now it's much harder to engage in sex trafficking and all these other horrible plagues, because people are people, they're identifiable people. Land registries, some of the other things you've heard, you have a gigantic asset class, like most countries in the world don't allow their citizens to own land. So imagine if suddenly you could own it, and now you have a pledgeable asset. That's trillions and trillions of dollars of unbanked economies. It's just called dead capital. So who would invest in them? Well, the people who want to do the right things with those assets would go into a digital exchange like that and find young people, find older people, and suddenly you are going to unleash demand and capital to connect those two things in ways that we have never seen. Because this is rather laughable. And I have the utmost respect for institutions like the SEC. We're extraordinarily mindful of coming up to any lines with them. But if you really think about the way we invest our money, we're bound by 1934 Security Act and 1940 Security Act. So maybe there's some updating that is required, and they're scrambling hard to keep up with the crypto and decentralizing world. We have fabulous attorneys who were at the SEC running the crypto practice, and it's an intellectual race to keep up with this, because the supply is coming, the demand is there. The supply are virtually any asset that's not digitized. So you can buy, you can download for 99 cents from Apple, right, a song that you love. But the actual catalog is not digitized, it's owned by the artist. The artist gets pushed around by record companies. Now the artist will not do that and won't refinance their own catalog. That happens to be a project we're working on. Artists in general, right, basically you pay the rent of your gallerist. They take no risk. But now we can digitize those assets, introduce new artists, and now whole new markets will be born. You need a mechanism like this to sort of connect people and to do the work to tokenize. As usual, I'm not even close to my script, so let me just see if I'm... I wanted to add an ism that maybe is a good one after getting rid of elitism, which I can't stand. Elitism, if you look at capitalism is a free market system, the best that we've known, but it always ends up with what I call guardians of the gate. There are sort of 4 to 5 groups. We used to have hundreds of investment banks, now we have 4. Hundreds of publishers, now we have 4. Hundreds of VCs, we have 4 or 5. Private equity, same thing. So they all go through the oligarchs. And the question will be, why would you do that when I could just go to my peer group? You basically have a lot of fat in that system that can be removed. And so I came up with an idea for the decentralized economy, which would be peopleism. Because people will really have the power. You will have the power of your brains and your feet to make decisions and lead those transactions. You don't need permission from someone to make those investments. And look no further than New York City. We had crypto week, which felt like crypto month. People don't sleep. And we took tours through, there's one right there, through Brooklyn. Williamsburg has sort of already been taken out, a lot of tech companies there. Now it's moving to Bushwick, which is a big warehouse center. Every single person you know in the crypto world would bet anything that that's the next pop. And now ask the economic elites on Wall Street, and you won't get the right answer. There's no chance. And so there's a book, The Wisdom of Crowds, that sort of captures that idea. We think that moment is really here. Centralized decision making by two geniuses doesn't work as well as a million people coming up with a new way to make the subways right on time. The blockchain will ensure more safety for IP. It's much more accountability. This is a phenomenal book. I've given out about 300 of them now called The Truth Machine, written by Paul Vignan, Michael Casey. Everyone should read this, The Truth Machine. That's the best book on the blockchain. And there's no, here's the pro and here's the con. It's here's the pro and you better get ready. And it is really, really well written. I was already a believer, but that helped me understand a few of these things. Why is that relevant? Because other guardians at the gate, like your favorite social media company or your favorite search engine, have all the data, and people don't like that. They haven't really rebelled yet, but they don't like that. And so I gave a talk in England a while ago, and at that time, Facebook was down $60 billion, all in a vote of non-trust. We don't like what you're doing, that's trust. So the last time a company went down by $60 billion, it was Lehman Brothers and almost sunk the financial system. But we wave it off because he has a $500 billion market capital. Stay tuned on that one, because I think the decentralized world is going to come up with a new way to connect people where you don't have to go through a central authority and deposit your data. And this will be a different way to own that data. Imagine if you move from, I don't know, pick a place, Beijing tomorrow, and they say, where are your health records? Your probable answer is, I have no clue. Could you think of anything more personal that you should own? You have no clue. And if you ask the doctor, they may not even have a clue. So these things are going to change. People are demanding them, and they have the tools to demand them. And now the technology, even as good as that might be today, this announcement we made, this will look like an abacus 5 years from now, but it's the best abacus in the market, and it's going to kick off this whole revolution. So I can keep going. I'm only allotted, oops. I thought I went yellow. I missed it. Is it possible to do a little Q&A or not?
No.
Come on. Oh. Why don't we let the people vote? See, they're centralized elitism. You're like one of my college professors who never liked me. Couple? Come on.
Yeah, we can take a couple minutes.
Sorry, I didn't mean to ramble so much.
Hi. Hi, you looking at me?
Sure.
Would you define blockchain?
Yeah. So there are all these headers when people say the crypto world and this or that. So people are using the blockchain as a catchphrase. It's literally a block of data that is sealed and confirmed by all the computers of the system, and then it moves on to another one and another one, and that forms a chain. So every 10 minutes, when I say I'm going to sell these things and I give all the money to charity, when all the computers of that system say that's indeed what happened, then it's closed, and then it's a closed block, and then we go to the next one because I keep selling. But the minute I take out 50% of my own dividend, the computers won't close the transaction. Sort of like on Wall Street, if you buy 100 shares of Apple at the wrong price, when it comes to your account, they call DK, don't know that transaction, and they send it back to you. But now all the computers of a system will validate that that transaction happened, and that is the block. And the next one, and the next one, and the next one, form the chain. Read that book, The Truth Machine. It's very good. I needed to read it about 8 times. Just. Anybody else? Yes, sir.
Todd, can you digitize a commodity like hydrogen? I produce hydrogen from waste. I produce hydrogen from waste. And the biggest challenge for me is that there's no pipeline infrastructure for hydrogen. And do you foresee a time when a commodity energy like hydrogen could be digitized?
When you say pipeline, a pipeline of deals or a pipeline to ship it?
Pipeline to ship it.
Yeah. I mean, I think taking it to its extreme, you would say, hey, we need $2 billion by next Friday, and I'm not interested in road shows and whatever, so I've done my paperwork, and it's very important that we connect hydrogen from A to B, and we need $2 billion for a pipeline, and can we fund